guys, Paul the DIY Guy here, and welcome to my nerd crafting vlog. Now, in the past you may have seen these containers that people make, where the idea is to take all the good things that happen to you throughout the year, write them on a piece of paper, and put them in a container. And they're usually always very Pinteresty looking. Which is not a bad thing, it's just something I'm not interested in having around the house. However, being a geek, I've come up with a solution that works better for me. So today, I'm gonna show you how to make a Mario block to keep track of all your good memories throughout the year. Check it out. You're going to need the following. 3/16 inch foam board, the pattern, make sure to print the sticker parts on sticker paper, some sewing pins, a rabbit cutter. Now, people have asked me where to get this last time, so I'll put a link in the doobly-doo to where you can get one. A utility knife, some glue, and a straight edge. I used a ruler. Start by cutting the squares out from the pattern. You can either do this by printing and cutting the squares out, or you can skip this part and measure out your squares instead. If you're using the pattern, mark the corners of the 6 squares. If you're just measuring, make 6 4-inch by 4-inch squares. Then, using the rabbit cutter, cut all 4 edges off the 2 squares, cut opposing edges of another 2 squares, and leave the last 2 squares intact. Now it's time to glue it all together. For the walls, we're going to alternate between the pieces with 2 edges cut and no edges cut. The pieces with all 4 sides cut will be for the top and bottom. Apply the glue along the area you cut out. Place a solid piece, and then pin them together. 2 pins should do it. Just make sure they hold the whole edge in place while it dries. Repeat this step, alternating between cutout and solid pieces until you've attached all 4 of them together in a box shape that's missing the top and bottom. Next, it's time to glue on the bottom. Glue around all 4 edges, and then tack it into place onto your just-made square. You'll need to let this sit for a while to dry, but we can work on the lid while that's happening. Cut out all your stickers out of the sticker paper. Now, I started by cutting out the black rectangle on the top piece first, but I should have waited until I had placed it on the foam first. Either way, you need to apply the sticker to the top piece, and then cut the rectangle carefully so it goes all the way through. Once your glue has had a chance to dry, pull all the pins out. Apparently, the head on one of mine wasn't stuck on well enough. I had to yank out the pin with my pliers. Whoops! It's time to put the rest of the stickers on. Start with the 2 that have a notch out of the top. Make sure that these go on opposite sides from each other. And once they're in place, cut out the white area very carefully using your utility knife. Lastly, place the remaining 2 side pieces in the bottom sticker in place. Put the lid on, and you're done. Enjoy your brand new Mario block. And that's all there is to it. If you'd like to make your very own, I'll put a link to the pattern down in the doobly-doo so you can do so. And now it's time for Viewercrafts! I'll start today's Viewercrafts off with Ash's manga shoes, which were based off my comic shoes vlog. They turned out great. Next up is fellow nerdfighter Chester, who's made some very interesting custom-made photo frames inspired by some of John Green's books. I really like the way these look. He's been gifting these out to some lucky friends since the Fault in Our Stars movie came out. Lastly is another game insert from forum moderator Molokov. This time it's from the game Tokaido, as seen on tabletop. This turned out extremely well. It's all well organized, and I love the way the lid opens with the ribbons. Very cool.
And as always, thank you so much for sending me the things that you make. I love seeing them. And if you would like to see your nerd crafts here on the vlog,
send me an email with some pictures to paulthediyguy@gmail.com.
And as always, I try to keep my crafts to Bro Geeks approved, and this one is definitely no exception. I had almost all the things I needed. I needed to restock on my foam board and some sticker paper. However, I use those for a lot of different things, so I will definitely be reusing them later. And as always, if you're looking for some tips and tricks on how to be a Bro Geek on a budget,
make sure to check out our 2 Bro Geeks. They got you covered.
And don't forget to check out my personal channel, where I put up a bunch of different stuff on a regular basis, so if you are interested in seeing more of this one, make sure to check that out. And as always, if you like this video, make sure to hit the like button. If you haven't done so already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you again in a fortnight, and until then, stay crafty, my friends.